station on Space to Ground.
Welcome to Space to Ground. I'm Leah Cheshire. The Quest airlock saw more action this week as two astronauts floated outside the station. On April 8th, NASA astronaut Anne McLean and Canadian Space Agency astronaut David Saint-Jacques completed the third and final spacewalk over the last 3 weeks. This was McLean's second spacewalk and the first for Saint-Jacques, who became the fourth Canadian to conduct an extravehicular activity. In 6 hours and 29 minutes, the astronauts relocated an adapter plate to continue work on the station's battery upgrades and routed cables to provide data connectivity for future camera upgrades. They also installed a backup power path to the station's robotic arm and slip-off prevention in preparation for the arrival of the Bartolomeo external payload platform next year. In the world of commercial crew, we have big news on one of the first flights with crew and new launch dates. NASA and Boeing agreed to extend the duration of their first crewed flight test to the station to several months, meaning when NASA astronauts Nicole Mann and Mike Fink join Boeing astronaut Chris Ferguson on Starliner, it'll be for a full-duration expedition flight. NASA and Boeing also updated the target launch dates for this year, with Starliner's uncrewed test flight now targeted for August and that first crewed flight in late 2019. Meanwhile, SpaceX is gearing up for their in-flight abort test with a new target date for the first crewed flight on Dragon coming soon. Hot off the press, results from the twin study on Scott and Mark Kelly after the one-year mission are in. In 2015, former NASA astronaut Scott Kelly began an almost one-year stay on the space station. During that time, he and his twin brother Mark were the research subjects on how the body changes and adapts to long-duration spaceflight. Scientists have published the findings, which you can read at nasa.gov/twinstudy. Keep sending in your questions using the hashtag SpaceToGround. We'll see you next week.